Hey everyone, it's Kevin. Welcome back to the channel. So in this video, I'm gonna walk through how to design something in 3D for 3D print, and specifically in Blender 3D. So I just got a 3D printer a few months ago, which is a Bambu Lab P1S. And if you wanna check out my first time 3D printing, I did an entire unboxing to a setup to my very first few prints. I'll put a link to that video below. Picking up 3D printing was pretty intimidating and daunting for me, but it's been so fun to be able to create things that are useful. In order to learn more about 3D printing, I've been trying to create things that are functional, and specifically things for a lot of the plants that I have here in my office. And that has been a really great experience because I'm learning a lot about how to optimize my design process and make things a lot more efficient. I created a few things already, like a trellis and a modular pot. So what I'm trying to do today is apply a lot of the stuff that I learned there to this project in this video. So I'm feeling pretty confident about this project, and it's going to be an ice cream cone inspired planter. I know that sounds kind of random, but I have this plant right here, and I have it in a clear plastic pot, kind of in this cone shaped clear plastic pot. And I wanted to create something for it because right now it kind of just lives in this bigger cup, and I have algae kind of growing on the side of it. So I want to be able to create another cover pot, just like what I did with my previous project. And if you want to check that one out, that was actually my very first pot. I'll put a link below as well. I felt like this was the perfect size to be able to create something fun with it. So this plant I actually got last year, it was really suffering. I wanted to do some sort of a rescue mission with it. So I've kind of been on a journey with this guy, but it's been really hard for it to start recovering, and it's now just coming back a year later. So it required a lot of patience, and I felt like it deserves something special. So for this project, I'm planning on creating something modular. So I'm intending to have perhaps a cone and then the cream, or like of what would be the ice cream of the ice cream cone, just on top, in order to make sure that I can cut down on any filament changes and just make sure that the design is as efficient as possible. Then that's my big focus today, is just to make sure that I'm designing efficiently and I'm understanding a bit more how I could optimize my design process. I also want to finish the pot so it doesn't necessarily look 3D printed. And specifically, I want to sand it down and seal it with some sort of sealer so that it looks like something that wasn't 3D printed. You know, the 3D prints that come out from the 3D printer or my Bambu Lab P1S has been really great. The quality has been really good. I just want to take it a step further and make it look a little nicer. So to start, I took measurements of the clear plastic pot first, and that was just recording the top and bottom diameters and then the height. So the height is about 2.5 inches and the top diameter is 2.25 and the bottom is 1.5. And once I had that, I started to visualize what that cone was going to look like around that shape. And I just drew some really quick visuals of what I was imagining. So I was thinking that the cone would come up about 2/3 of the way, and the last 1/3 and a little bit more was going to be the cream. So the filament I was going to be using was the Bambu Lab Matte PLA. So I have a dark brown, a light brown, and a pink. And I was thinking that I could perhaps add some white somewhere. And although this printer is capable of multicolor printing, I wanted to minimize the amount of filament changes it was going to have to do, and that's because that increases the printing time, and I wanted to make sure I minimize that. So I decided to make this a modular pot where I would print the cone first and then I would print the cream afterwards. I know that especially for the cream, because it's a shape that is very rounded and it has overhangs meaning that it'll require supports, that is also going to be wasting a lot of filament, but I figure maybe for this project, it was going to be fine just to see what that was like. Once I had the design, I opened a new Blender file, and the first thing I did was go to the Scene Properties tab and change the unit scale to 0.001. This is to make sure that I was working in units transferable to the slicer software I was using, which was Bambu Lab Studio. Then I set the units to millimeters, which is what is used for 3D printing. I brought in a cylinder for the clear plastic pot and then another one for the outer pot, which was going to be the ice cream cone. And then I just started modeling a simple cake cone. I rounded out the top half of it and then started creating that waffle portion using the wireframe modifier and poke faces. Then I moved on to creating the cream, which was just a bezier circle that I added some thickness to, and then I used the sculpt tools in order to form it into a cream shape. And then I added another mesh on top of it to kind of create this like half closed scoop. And then I had both components modeled and done. I also shaded it in the colors of the filament just to give a sort of visual. In the slicer software, Bambu Studio, I was going to print both of the meshes on the same plate at the same time, but like I said, I wanted to minimize the amount of filament changes, and here it was going to be about 437, and the time was going to be 19 hours, so I opted to just print them one at a time. And so I deleted the cream and then just started off with the cone and then printed the cream afterward. For a while, I wasn't sure what this tower was, but apparently it's called a purge tower and it's used to clean the nozzle every time that it switches colors. And so the nozzle purges the leftover filament from the previous color, and this is just to avoid any kind of mixing of colors and ensure that the correct color is printed. Another thing that I really wanted to figure out was the pattern, the surface pattern when 3D printing. So the ones that I've used so far are monotonic, rectilinear, and concentric. From my understanding, monotonic is best for visual surfaces when you want a smooth finish, so like decorative items or something functional. Rectilinear is for things that are structural or things that need some support. And then concentric is great for curved surfaces like bowls or vases. So for the cream, I used the concentric pattern, and then for the cone, I just used monotonic. And then I moved on to printing it out. So I started off with that ice cream cone, and I ended up using two different filament colors. I had a dark brown for the bottom of the cone and then a light brown for the top. After printing it out, I was thinking maybe I should have increased the resolution because there were some banding lines on the top portion of the cone, but I figured I could remove that with sanding. And then I tested out the plot inside and it fit pretty well. I then moved on to printing out the cream, and like I mentioned before, this required supports. This is my first time printing with supports, so I wasn't sure how that was going to be, but it was pretty easy as soon as I understood how it was going to attach itself to the rounded mesh, and all I had to do was just remove it. It did take a little bit, but as soon as I finished, I was able to sand out all of the other artifacts and it ended up okay. Unfortunately, I messed up with the print. So the cone itself was fine, but when I printed the cream, I guess I didn't boule it correctly. It actually didn't fit on top of the cone. So I had to reprint it out, which took a few hours, but afterwards that was fine. I needed to remind myself that I have to just check all of my models first before I print it out so that I could just make sure everything fits. So everything worked out, but I think there are a few things to keep in mind when designing for 3D printing in Blender 3D. One of the main things is to make sure your model is manifold, which means there are no gaps or holes. And to help out with this, we can actually use an add-on called the 3D Print Toolbox. To enable it, you go to Edit, Preferences, and as of Blender 4.2, it's Get Extensions and install it from there. Once installed, you can access it from the side menu by pressing N in the viewport. And here you'll have a couple of different options that'll help with optimizing your 3D model for print. Another tip is to apply scale, rotation, and location for accurate prints. Keep walls at least 1 to 2 millimeters thick for strength. Watch for overhangs that might need supports because, again, you can end up using a lot of filament for that. And then use the Boolean modifier correctly, unlike what I did, to merge any intersecting geometry into a single unified mesh. So after I had the 3D prints done, I moved on to sanding and finishing. And like I said, I just used stuff that I already had. So I had a 180 grit sanding cube, and I just used that on the ice cream cone, on the rounded parts in order to kind of remove some of those banding lines that were created during the print process. And again, because I didn't really increase the resolution there. And then I also did the same for the cream on the top, just trying to go and sand down a lot of the rounded edges. After, I did use an acrylic base sealer, which is this Krylon Crystal Clear. This was really great. I had this left over from another handcraft project, and this gave the shine and finish that I was looking for. I went over with two coats. One coat is usually fine, but two coats just makes it a lot more even. So I just sprayed it really quickly on both the cone and the cream, and I, you know, let it dry for a few minutes. And this is the result. I'm really happy with how this ice cream cone turned out. I think it looks great, and I really like all the finishing that I did. There are a few things that I wish I could have changed, like make the cream a little smaller and have it sit a little higher, but overall I am happy with the result and looking forward to the next one. And that's it for this project. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I know this was kind of an out of the box project, but I did learn a lot from it, and I feel like I'm actually picking up 3D printing, which is awesome. Anyways, if you have any questions or comments or tips that you'd like to share with me, feel free to leave them below. And if you'd like to check out any of those other videos that I had, like my first time 3D printing or the other practical prints videos that I created, I'll leave links to all of them in the description. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next video.